Hi, thanks so much for joining me on Patreon for this. This is my first proper listen to Ultraviolence by Lana Del Rey start to finish. Here's where I am with it. I heard it once when it came out, then I heard West Coast about 100 times because I got obsessed with that song. I honestly don't think I've heard the rest of the album at all. Next month I'm going to do the next album, which is Honeymoon, I think, is that right? Whichever one the next one is, I'm going to do like her entire discography one a month, and that'll take us up to Christmas. January might start a new tier, we'll see how it goes. So, Ultraviolence, here we go. I remember there being a really slow song that started it. The soundscape of this is amazing. That was an insane start to the album. Speaking of crazy, that was absolutely just, it was intense, very intense. I know she's had intense songs before at this point, but to start an album with a song that slow is so bold. I love the lyrics, I love I've Got Your Bible and Your Guns. Reminds me of like Marilyn Manson lyrics, but also I think she's referencing, well, probably like he was, the religious right in America, double standards, that kind of thing. Amazing singing, quite throaty, quite raw. I wonder if she's the kind of singer, a bit like Madonna maybe, where she'll just go in and do like one or two takes and that's it. Wow. What a chorus. Wow. This is great. I'm taking notes, by the way. I can hear sirens. He hit me and it felt like a kiss. That's like a violent scene. The police are on the way. The ambulance is on the way. And then I can hear violins. And there were some amazing strings in this too. And she's saying, give me all that ultraviolence. Just give it to me. Again, it's a bit like in the first song, maybe that wasn't abusive. Maybe that was like an unwanted partner kind of thing. Whereas in this, it seems like a full-on, like, abusive relationship. And she's kind of fine with it. Her point of view, it's not one that exists before, I don't think. But I can't fix it. Can't make him better. And I can't do nothing about this strange weather. What a line. In that one, she sounds like she does care. In the first couple, she sounded a bit indifferent. In this one, it sounds like she actually would like to change him. Like she's tried and she wants to. There's definitely some regret in there or some longing to change that. Don't know it. Feathers in my hair, I get down tell if she's mocking people like that, or if she is one, or both. If you put a gun to my head and asked me to name my favourite lyricist and songwriter of all time, the answer would be Lou Reed. I might listen to like David Bowie or Neil Young or some other dudes a lot more, but Lou Reed is the best for me. So any reference to him, I'm over the moon. That warms my heart. In fact, was it this album or this song that she was going to do a duet with him and he died? I mean, absolute tragedy. It would have been amazing seeing what those two would come up with together. I bet he would have liked her. I bet he did. But you know, I thought she was maybe making fun of that slightly, but actually, in the middle bit, she was saying, like, I'm talking about my generation, and it sounded like she was being sincere. You know, I think that was purely sincere, talking about where she came from, the people she hung out with, and maybe, tellingly, the first song on the album so far that doesn't feature her in, like, an abusive or unhappy relationship or something. Okay, this one I know. I never got that lyric. I'm alive, I'm a lush. Amazing production. Why does she throw Spanish in there every now and again? No reason not to, but I like it, I like it. Great guitar. It's quite bluesy and jazzy, this one. Yeah. Gonna be good. Twin Peaks reference. I need like an alarm that goes off every time there's a Twin Peaks reference on the action. Okay. It's funny. Great chorus, this song's amazing. The production across this whole album is amazing. Dan Auerbach, is that how you say his name? Great job, great job. I didn't like his band, whatever they were called. The Black Keys? Not for me, but the production work I've heard from him has been amazing. Great song too. I love the idea of calling it Sad Girl, because she was kind of known for like big sad ballads, wasn't she? I know there's more to her than that. But if the only song of hers you knew was Video Games, I bet people were telling her to smile all the time as well. At first, I thought her character was quite delusional, you know, being someone's bit on the side and kind of saying, well, you know, you don't know my man, he's great, you know, if you knew him, you'd understand why I'm doing this. But actually, as the song goes on, she gets more defiant. She's saying, like, watch what you say to me, careful who you're talking to. There's something quite bold and powerful and beautiful about that. She's kind of owning whatever mistakes that she's making or that society thinks she's making and kind of going, well, take it or leave it, this is me. Great vocal. Must be a first take. Love it. That's such a funny thing to say. She might mean it, but imagine someone saying that to you in real life. I love it. Brutal. Brutal. That's a really deep, complex one. That'll need a few more lessons. That character is almost trying to get in situations where she cries, because then she'll be pretty. It's kind of like, you know, she needs it. She feeds off heartbreak and heartache, because that's where she feels the best, where she looks the best. Don't know. There's something of that in there. I want money. Beautiful singing on that one, going up into a higher register, so agile up there. It just sounded so ethereal and free. I love the music on that one. It's very laid back and very epic, very relaxing to listen to. Lyrically, it left me a little bit cold. I'm not quite sure I got the point of it. So maybe if you've got like an interpretation of that or that song means something to you, then feel free to, you know, feedback and tell me what I've missed. Awesome. Life is awesome. Oh. Awesome, I agree. To me, that's almost the perfect song. Musically, it's amazing. It's so driving and sort of insistent, that rhythm of it. Her vocals were very, very on the edge, very almost like hysterical at times. And the lyrics and the song title, I love that. I'm going to assume, like Sad Girl, this is another one where someone has said that about her, that she fucked away to the top, implying that like talent wasn't a factor, purely just the fucking. And I can only imagine that people have said that about her, thought that about her, and she's taken it on like a badge of honour and gone, right, maybe I do. Let's do a song about it. I mean, just imagine any other female artist having the courage or the wit or the sense of humour to call a song that and make it like a really good, passionate, amazing song. But I just love the way her lyrics sound. They can be read like poetry, but when she sings them, it doesn't sound like someone singing poetry. It doesn't sound clumsy or clunky. They're just great poetic lyrics. And again, sense of humour, very important to me. That's a big component of this. Just a bit of wit, a bit of self-awareness, a bit of humour goes a long way. Will you still love The strings on this song are stunning. The whole album, really. But the way they just faded in there was so nice. I'll come to you, I'll come to you, I'll come, come, come. Ooh. Vocal. Amazing. Amazing. If you change your mind, I'll come, come, come. Beautiful song. That was gorgeous. Before I forget, let's go back and listen to the way she sang I'll Run, 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 because that was incredible. And if you call, I'll run, run, run. Heaven. Heaven. And if you call, right, if I'm keeping track okay, I think that's the second last song on the album, so it sounds like it's kind of becoming more positive as it goes on. I mean, that song was about the past, maybe not the present, but it seems like that wasn't ironic, it wasn't seedy, it didn't have a double meaning, just some lovely poetic lyrics and very expressive singing as well. Those wordless vocalising things that she does. Gorgeous, absolutely amazing. I think we've got one song left, let's go. The other one. So this is the Nina Simone cover, I think. It's time to manicure nails. The other woman is perfect where rival failed. The other woman will never have his love to keep. And as the years go by, if she ever wants to do a jazz album, she can. Incredible singing. Let's go straight back to that gap. As the years go by, the other woman was real. Her life alone. That was an amazing way to finish that album, that song. I've never heard the Nina Simone original. I've heard some of her stuff, but not loads. She really waited till the end to show off everything she could do with her voice. That was so, so impressive. Okay, so there you go. That is Ultraviolence. That is about as close to perfect as an album like that gets. If Born to Die is about an 8 out of 10, and Paradise EP is about a 9, which I don't do ratings, but that's kind of maybe what I'd say. This is a 10. This is a 9.5. It's a 10. It's a kind of perfect, career-defining masterpiece. It obviously is. And the production is amazing too. These feel a bit more timeless than some of the productions on Born to Die, at least. Very organic, clean guitars, lush strings. It just sounded like a luxury album or something like that, you know? And sometimes the lyrics matched that, and sometimes they were funny and kind of went against the intensity of the music. To me, it kind of feels like it started dark and then got lighter as it went on. I was almost thinking she moved to LA halfway through, like West Coast is her going from New York to LA, but I'm not sure if that's true. There's some kind of journey on the album, though, about acceptance or making better decisions or looking to the past and understanding who she is. Okay, that's almost it. But one other random thought, this might not make sense. Is she to that decade what Amy Winehouse was to the decade before? Is there a similarity there? Something about being jazzy and bluesy, taking music from the past, but updating it musically and having like honest lyrics that are quite funny, sexual, quite modern, like swear words, stuff like that. Covering Nina Simone, I'm pretty sure Winehouse has done that. I mean, her influences seem to be more like classic rock, Lou Reed, that kind of stuff. I don't know, there's some similarities in there, maybe just for me, but I get something out of her music that I used to get from Amy Winehouse's music, so that's a pretty big compliment coming from me. Right, thank you for watching this, thanks very much for your time, and please comment, let me know what some of your favourite songs are, what they mean to you, and let me know what to do next. Thanks a lot. Baby, like I'm breathing, baby. Need you, baby.